Φωτκή, μια μίσελη λιπάνα σώνα πιτώ γιπώνετα.
Day 6, compound sentences.
Tokipona does this thing where its sentences have a very clear structure. There's one thing, though. What do you do if you want to say something more complicated than a simple subject-verb-object sentence allows? For example, what if there are multiple objects with the same predicate? What if there are multiple predicates with the same subject? First of all, let's get one thing clear. If you look through a Tokipona dictionary, you'll find the word N, which means and. However, N is not used for compound sentences. We'll go over its actual purpose in a later lesson. The way you make compound sentences is so basic it doesn't even need its own rule number. If you need multiple predicates, just do multiple predicates. If you need multiple objects, just do multiple objects. For example, try translating this. Mi moku e kala e kiri. It's I eat fish and fruit. How about this? Pipi li lapa li moku. That's bug, sleep, and eat. The only other thing really worth noting here is that you need to repeat e for objects and li for predicates. You also need the second li if the subject is me or Sina. Here, say, you are good and you see books and people. It's a bit tricky, but it's Sina pona li lukin e lipu e yan. Let's do vocab. Len means fabric or clothing. Kiwen means stone, metal, or any other hard object. Kon means air, any other gas, or something invisible. Boki means box or container. Musi means entertainment or art. Awen means continue or stay. Soali means animal, although it implies land mammal. Olin means love. Sin means new, additional, or extra. This is a short one. Study the vocab we literally just did. Itawa. Are you still watching? Cool. Well, we're at the halfway point now, and as it turns out, at least 5 people are actually watching this, and I'd like to know something about them so I can make these lessons as good as possible. So, there's a survey in the description of this video that you can participate in if you want. Okay, mitawa.